You come into the threshold of another starless night of fear. You're running from the demons that would drag you down again. Illusions.
Okay, so the story takes place when I was around 14, 15 years old. You know, grade school years. I was really into after MySpace, Facebook, probably. I was really into chat rooms. Now, if you grew up in the 90s, you knew how early 2000s, you know how chat room was the thing. And asking, what's your ASL? What's your ASL? Your age, sex, location. And so, I would hip hop to different chat rooms when I was, you know, 14, 15, see what's going on. I grew up, if you follow my channel, please follow my channel, like and subscribe. I grew up in a Christian household. I wasn't really allowed to have boyfriends. So the most intimacy I ever got was really from online. And so, I was never like subscribed to eHarmony and stuff. I wasn't, I guess, taking it that serious, but I knew that I would just go to chat rooms. And there'd be many different categories of chat rooms. There'd be anime, love, sex, celebrities, like a whole different categories of chat rooms. I would be like in the main biggest chat room with teens, preteens from all around the world, just talking it up with them. And one day, I was in a chat room, and you know, sometimes there are older people that lie about their age that be in a chat room. So I was talking to this guy, he was from Texas, and he actually told me his real age was like 30 years old. And mind you, at this time, I was 14, 15, so as you know, there were some pedophiles up in there, obviously. And so, I decided, most likely it was a fake picture, I don't know, but I liked what I saw, and so we decided to DM each other. And so he asked a question like, could we be in a relationship? Do you like what you see? I want to be with you, blah, 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 blah. And I'm like, oh no, I don't want that. Nah, I'm not feeling it. Something along those lines. And then he said, okay, well, F you, nigger, N-I-G-G-E-R. And when he said that, I was just so shocked and surprised. That was the first time I actually had racism happen to me. Because as my father, he's from Trinidad. And so his mother is still kind of under the queen mindset. But they're all so happy that I came out light skin or whatever. But, I guess they didn't think it could happen to me. And mind you, my mom, she's gorgeous, like a model type, but like she's very, very dark. Not like Ethiopian dark, but like just dark. But she was really dark and beautiful. She was a Black Panther. And so I know she must have experienced some type of like racism. Even sure she told me she'd never have, but I'm sure there was like subtle at least. And so the first time I actually got called a nigger at 14, 15 was just shocking, because my mom was all teaching. We had already read the book, How to Make a Slave. And so like for that to even be, you know, those words to be, you know, sprouted at me in a derogatory manner, it was just shocking. I didn't expect it at all. I'm still kind of like, whoa, to this day about it. Like, I don't see white people as the devil. As my mom would say, there are some that left the light on for us. There are some good white people out there. But especially in this Trump era, all the racist whites and racist people, period, are just coming out of the closet. And it's ridiculous. I mean, it's good to know who these people are, but there needs to be like a complete like educational cleansing up in here. It's ridiculous. So much hate. It makes no sense. So I was very shocked and hurt. Definitely. I actually cried because I'm like, wow, because I already understood the meaning of that word. So for it to really happened to me, for someone to say that to me, it was just like, wow. I was just shocked and hurt. Even at that age, I was just really shocked and hurt. It still kind of affects me to this day. Like, if someone gets mad at me, I'm scared if they're going to call me a nigger again or not. It's crazy. And this was from a nobody. He wasn't close to me, just a stranger online. It's crazy. And it's crazy because I have a lot of, I have a mix of friends, but I have a lot of Spanish friends, and they say N-I-G-G-A, nigga, with the A around me, all the time, and some of my other friends too. But one time is my close friend Richard, he got after me about the one time I did say nigga, in the friendly way, not the derogatory way, and he got on me immediately. He's like, do not say that. I don't care if we black, it's not right to say that. And I completely retracted myself. So if I could be open enough to retract it and not say it, I don't say it anyway, period. But he really I really appreciate him doing that for me and correcting me. And I really make sure not to say it, no matter if it's around me or not. Now, do I think Spanish people should say it? I don't think anyone should say it, period. I mean, I understand how you're changing nigger to nigga and making it kind of like a friendly context, a friend context, turning a negative into a positive. I get that. But down to the end of the line, down to the origins, no one should say that. White people really shouldn't say that. If nigger comes out of a white person's mouth, the friendly way or the derogatory way, that person should get slapped outside the ass. I'm sorry. You should get slapped. You should get punched. I don't condone violence. I don't. But for anyone to say that, especially a white person, a peppermint patty, anybody to say that, oh God, they should get slapped for real. For real. Someone said that to me in person. I don't care. I'm not violent, but you're getting slapped. Plain and simple. So the fact that someone called me that back then really hurt me. And as I reflect through my life now and the people around me that say it, yes, Puerto Ricans, because most of my friends are, it's a mix, but most of them are Puerto Rican. And the fact that they do got their origins are black, they do have some black in them in addition to Taino and everything, they still shouldn't say it. In my opinion, no one should say the N-word, period. Point blank. It should be erased from the Merriam-Webster dictionary. No one should be saying that word. End of story. End of story. Yes, I know for Nas, we should be called Kings or something. What is that name? Nasir, N-E-G-U-S. Instead, we should be called niggas, kings, not niggas. This is Sharday with C's today. Thank you so much for following my channel. I appreciate each and every one of my 61 subscribers out there. Thank you. You don't know how much it means to me. I'm surprised I even have this many subscribers, honestly. So thank you for even supporting me and hearing me talk. I appreciate it. Be sure to like and subscribe for more content like this. Do you agree that the N-word should be said? Who should say it? Comment down below your thoughts. I would love to hear them and have a discussion in the comment section. Thank you so much for your time and taking the time out of your day to watch my videos. And until the next video, goodbye, fine folks.